Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back for another episode of Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Minish Cap. I know it's been a while, but hey, what do you expect from me, GrandPyromania, your host? And in this episode, we're going to be doing quite a few things, which hopefully include going up to Mount Crenel. Alright, so first things first, what we want to do is go into this big store with the rupee on top, and go over here and just bring that over to the shopkeeper. It's only 80 rupees for a wallet, and it can hold a king's ransom in rupees. A king's ransom, you say? Well, I don't plan on ransoming the king anytime soon, but that's certainly a good boisterous thing to have. So by doing that, we get an upgraded wallet. So instead of 100 rupees, we can hold up to 200 or 300, I believe. Alright, so second thing second, I do want to show you guys this minigame, okay? First and foremost, let's talk to her. And let's see, can you catch them for me? Of course. So this is a little mini game in which you can get quite a bit of rupees, and you can't go inside buildings or anything, so really it's quite easy, and it's nice to get a few rupees before we go in, because we are going to need quite a few rupees before we do anything. Now, this golden cuckoo is worth quite a lot, actually, and what I like to do is just sort of throw him towards the fence here, and just kind of throw him in, and then let's see if we can't actually get one more. We can't, but time's up, that's it. And for our troubles, we will get 10 mysterious shells, but that's not the only thing. You got 70 rupees. Doesn't it feel good to help others? So yeah, we also get 70 rupees for our troubles, and that does make life quite a bit easier, especially, you know, considering that we're just going to be doing so much more. I don't have any kinstone pieces. What? I totally have a few kinstone pieces. Clearly, this game is just hating. But what we have to do is go into this wooden roofed house that has, like, the chick on it. So, let's go inside, and let's talk to this dude.
I am Swiftblade, finest swordsman in all of Hyrule. If you train with me, I guarantee that you will increase your skill dramatically. So, would you like to train here?
Yes. We shall start with the most basic of all techniques. I shall teach you the spin attack. Ah, yes, the spin attack, the most iconic of all of the Zelda sword techniques. I love how, like, as I was talking, I lost my train of thought, so you guys very clearly heard me struggling in order to, you know, get that out, but hey, we got to it, and let's just go ahead and charge up our blade and the spin attack. There we go. Your quick study, I will now give you this tire scroll. If you ever forget this technique, you can review it with this scroll. You may view it any time from the quest status screen. And we learn the secret spin attack fighting technique. This is the first sword technique you've learned from Master Swiftblade. So whenever we get upgrades and stuff, or, you know, complete something that's essential to the story, we can pretty much go back to Master Swiftblade and learn from him, because we are just a budding flower, and he is our watering can of knowledge and power and youth. Alright, let's talk to you, Mr. Guard.
Ho ho! So you've learned the spin attack! It's still dangerous, but maybe you can handle it. Well, let's see how you do. Show me that spin attack! So let's just go up ahead and spin attack! Yeah, that's the one! But there are monsters out there, kid. You make sure you're careful.
Sir, I'm, like, always careful. I mean, pshaw, right? Okay, like, my name is Link Careful Smith. Yeah, Smith. That's definitely... Okay, let's go down here, right? And as you can see, there appears to be a bumble wall. So we're gonna do what any good Samaritan would do and blow up the wall. You know, potentially, you know, make way for a potential caveman, but luckily we lucked out there. Yes, it's quite lucky we lucked out, so... Let's go ahead and take care of this Deku Scrub, and you can have this most deluxe of all bottles for only 20 rupees. 20 rupees does seem like quite a steal, especially considering we will need it to climb Mount Crenel. Alright, so let's go ahead and go back up through this ladder thing, and let's go towards the left! Towards the left, I say! And get that out of the way. Did you get out of the way, you... Alright, so this is Mount Crenel's base. Of course, first and foremost, what we're going to be doing here is blowing up this wall, because there may be goodies inside, and you know me, I like myself some goodies. Let's see, what have you got to say, Mr. Scrub? I'll make it up to you by telling you something good. Oh, come on.
Come on. We already know this. We're super smart. We're already ahead of the bell curve here. All right, so let's go ahead and fill up this empty bottle with spring water. So what we gotta do is pour it on this plant thing here, and by defying all physics, we make the vine grow up. However, that's not what we want to do quite yet, because as you guys can see here, there is a red rupee worth 20. So instead of 54, we have 74. So it's basically like that bottle was free, you know? So it's a nice little thing. If you don't have rupees, you can just go ahead and use that. Now we got some new monsters, but they go down, and they don't go down quite easily. I would suggest having the gust jar out for a good amount of it, because these white things will hurt you if you go on top of it, and it can make your life just a bit annoying. And there are some enemies you can't really do much except blow on them. So let's go ahead, and there's a wall here, but it doesn't look like there's anything you would notice, so I say we still blow it up anyway. And well, look at that, my instinct is good. All right, so let's just go ahead and do that. Of course, we have more red chews, or well, not more, but we got red chews for the first time ever, and easy to go down. They're pretty much exactly the same, just takes two hits. And so what we want to do, right, is go ahead and blow up this rock here. Go ahead and let that explode. There we go. And let's go ahead and shrink down to the size of the Minish. Oh yes, the size of the Minish. Because, as you can see, we went ahead and just created our own little way. We didn't lose our way, you see. Because you don't want to lose your way. Otherwise, Kirin Ragio will mess with you. Alright, so let's just go ahead and go through here. Now, we are cheating a little bit, but hey, it's okay. That's what a Let's Play is for. Oh, unfortunately, that didn't rhyme with the A sound as I was trying, and I know. I'm sure you guys are thinking, you disappoint me, Jay. Oh, yeah, I brought it back. Oh, didn't see that coming, did you? I'm on top of my game today. Oh, see what I did there? You do want to avoid those giant rocks. They hurt a lot. And so, over here, there's random green water. Now, your mommy and daddy probably told you not to touch green water, but it turns out that's actually Crenel hot spring water. Yes, apparently hot spring water is green for some reason. I wish I could tell you guys. I wish I could, but let's just chalk it up to global warming and, you know, call it a day. How about that? Alright, so let's go ahead and go back to normal size, and what we're going to be doing is, of course, going back through this little cave thing. Luckily, it's not too big. So, let's go ahead and head on over to the left, take care of these jumper thingies that were, like, in every Zelda game ever. I just keep forgetting their name. Let's see, what am I... Yeah, so there's another cave over here. Hopefully, I think this is going to have another Deku Scrub in it. And I think it's... No, it isn't. Okay. Actually, in that case, it's probably in this cave. Yeah. And, because the thing is that I believe he actually sells bombs. And normally, I would definitely recommend not buying it from him, but I am so super sure it's kind of crazy. So, I'm going to bite the bullet. And the thing is, though, is that you will need at least 40 rupees going forward. So, when you start Mount Crenel, it would probably be the best idea to have 60 and, of course, like a full bomb patch thing. Or not bomb patch, but bomb pouch, excuse me. Yeah, you definitely want to have full bombs and at least 60 rupees before you start Mount Crenel. You know, I feel like I probably should have said that going into Mount Crenel, but eh. Once you've pulled off their iron masks, these guys are no trouble whatsoever. Yeah, they really aren't. And let's just go ahead and toss that. And I got 5 bombs there. Alright, well, we can go ahead and just toss him over into pots. And let's just go ahead and do it. You can pretty much just keep sucking until they come into your gust jar. And you can just kill them easily without even having to expend any extra effort. So, effort, making things effortless is always good. Ah, of course, how silly of me. My boy, jump into that vortex over there. I've got an idea.
So basically, what we can do is we can float in the air using those little cyclone thingies. So let's go ahead and do just that. And that was quite simple, if you ask me. Now, what we have to do is just blow away some of this dust. Oof, so much dust. All right, and what we have to do is just kind of blow all this away, and whoa, there just so happens to be a very convenient Minish stone. Let's go ahead and clear that and go on top of it and shrink back down to the size of the Minish. We're gonna become Minishcule! I do wish it would let you skip that singing scene, but it doesn't. Alas, Yoax. All right. So let's just go ahead and go over here and just kind of come here. There we go. And now we can lift. Bro, do you even lift? Because Link most certainly does. Oh, yes, he lifts quite a bit. He's a strong little guy. And the funny thing is he can't pick up stuff like this when he's normal size, which is kind of odd, but hey. All right, so let's go ahead and go back to where the Minish stone is. Here it is. Attaboy. And let's just go ahead and suck all that away so we don't have to deal with it. And if you guys remember, we got that hot spring water. So what we're just gonna go ahead and do is pour on top of that, because that will let us go up. However, we're not going up quite yet, because I do want to explore a little bit. It's funny, I've gone through this part like a million and a half times, but every now and again, I just like to explore. I like to be like, yo, what's going on here? What's the happy, yo? Dog? Homie? Oh god, I'm gonna desist from doing that, because it turns out everything sent me a cease and desist letter saying, yeah, don't do that. And I'm like, aw, please. And yay, we blew that up. And for our troubles, we get a piece of heart. So now we only need two more before we get the full heart container. And let's just go ahead and blow up both of these blocks here, because we get 50 rupees. Oh my, 50 rupees is quite nice. And we also get a kinstone piece, which is wonderful, actually. So, aren't you guys glad that I didn't end up climbing up? Because we got 50 rupees, we got a kinstone piece, and we got, most importantly, a piece of heart. Oh yeah, so we are rolling in the goods. And the best part is, if we get more rupees going forward, right? Because we upgraded our wallet, we're not gonna have to worry about it, you know, becoming too much. Because we will have all the rupees in the world. We can pay a king's bounty or ransom, whatever. See, we have 101 rupees. Someone call Cruella DeVille because she's gonna be after me. Wait, so then you wouldn't want to call her? I don't know. I'm just going with the flow. Yo. All right, let's blow that up. Yo, nice. There we go. And whoa, ladies and gentlemen, do you see this? Not only are we gonna catch a fairy, right? But we're gonna get another piece of heart. How awesome is that, right? And the funny thing is, I actually didn't know this was here. I'm not joking. I've played through this part at least 4 or 5 times, right? Because I want to make absolutely sure that I know what I'm doing for you guys. And I didn't know that was there. That's a little sad. That's a little sad, but you know what? It's okay, because improvisation is definitely a Let's Player's best thing. You just roll with the flow, yo, do, bo, co, to, po, po. I don't know. Whatever. Words are hard. Okay, guys. And eventually, when it comes to commentary, you just end up making random noises. You live long enough to make bad commentary, or wait. Yeah, you know what? I'm not even gonna bother, because I butchered that quote already, and so the joke is gone. The joke is gone! Forever! Or maybe not forever, just for the next little while. Alright, so these shoes are a bit different. They turn into those weird explosions, or they turn into that weird thing, where basically they become alternative art, but in all reality, like, what happens is they become invulnerable, and so you have to wait until they're in that form, like, right there. As you can see, there we go, their spiky form. There we go, and
It does get kind of annoying, but pretty much as soon as they come out of that spiky, invulnerable form, right, you can just go ahead and beat them back. So, let's go ahead and fly over yonder. I'm sure you guys can tell that we have to follow these cyclones. Alright, and let's see. What does Mr. Sign say? Crenel Mines, Crenel Wall. Alright, so we definitely want to be going to the Crenel Mines, but we also want to be doing stuff like this. Because, hey, who knows, right? We were over there. So we don't need to go over there. So let's go up towards the Crenel Mines. Because here's the thing, right? We don't have a way to climb the wall. The wall! It keeps all the wildlings out. But yeah, we need to find a way to climb the wall. And when we do find that way, then we can go ahead and climb the wall to our heart's content. And that's a shortcut to the bottom. What's inside this little manly cave here? Ooh, you know, that might actually contain what we're looking for. Hello, Mr. Scrub. Let me make it up to you. Grip ring! There we go. So you do need the grip ring, because the grip ring will allow you to climb and do things to that nature. So walls like this, we can now climb. Oh yes, so we're pretty dang spiffy right now, if you ask me. Unfortunately, there's nothing we can do here quite yet. It will take a little while before we can do stuff to that nature, but yeah, just kind of showing you guys that yes, we can climb over yonder. Alright, so let's go ahead and climb on over. Nope, not here. For some reason, I thought it was over here. I'm just going crazy, guys, but I'm sure you all knew that already. My name's GrandPyromania, and I'm going crazy, but you knew that already. So let's go ahead and climb up the Crenel Wall, Mount Crenel Wall. Now, it will be dropping these rocks, and I don't really have a good strategy for avoiding them. Just, you gotta stay constantly vigilant and try to move out of the way when stuff like this happens. So, however, as we're climbing, right, you actually want to go down here over to the right, and you want to take the bombs, blow up this wall, because we know that despite the fact that there's no bombable wall, there's something we can throw there, right? And here is a fountain of some sort. Well, what if we try throwing a bomb into that fountain? I wonder what will happen then. Let's see, shall we? Welcome to the Adventurer Spring. Did you throw the golden bomb into the spring or the silver bomb? So this is kind of a troll. Well, not really, but this is really stupid design, in my opinion. You can't actually go down, but what you want to do is select neither, and you actually have to keep scrolling to the right. You can't actually just go down. You're honest. I must reward such an honest adventurer with some of my power. And we got the big bomb bag. Now you can carry more bombs.
May you fare well in your quest.
Alright, so we now have 30 bombs. I think that's actually a good spot to end things here. So, in the next episode, we're going to continue climbing the Crenel Mountain, and hopefully we'll actually get to where we need to go. So, this is GrandPyromania signing out. I'll see you guys next time for some more Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Minish Cap, and it'll be in a more timely manner.